Innovation is the cornerstone of all revolutionary actions in the world today. As life throws up new challenges every moment, the demand for ideas that stand apart from the ordinary is ever more essential. This is why, over the years, we have endeavored to create projects that exemplify the true essence of innovation. We are a group of motivated young women striving to make a difference. We are Enactus Jesus and Mary College.
In stinking lanes choked with garbage, in areas devoid of sewage, drainage or running water live 65 million Indians. Out of this, close to 1.9 million slum dwellers die due to inadequate hygiene and sanitation. One primary reason for this colossal loss of life is the lack of basic hygiene practices among the urban poor. The elementary yet effective solution that acts as preventive medicine for grave sanitation-related illnesses is just a bar of soap. We sometimes fail to realize that this life-saving commodity that we often take for granted eludes many in India and around the world. According to the World Health Organization, 2,97,000 children die each year due to the absence of one simple habit. Hand washing.
In contrast to this, there are people who during their hotel stay use the soap bar only for a few washes. A large chunk of it gets discarded and ends up in landfills or water bodies, polluting our soil, seas and rivers. On an average, a typical 400-room hotel generates 3.5 tons of solid soap waste every year. This compelling irony propelled us to launch Project IFAT in November of 2017.
Project IFAT works proactively to tackle this predicament. Its novel undertaking promotes the ecological management of water resources and improves sanitation. The ingenious approach followed by the project allows for it to propagate both social impact and full circle use of sanitation utilities. It does so by upcycling the barely used soap bars from hotels, turning them into new ones and subsequently selling them in low-income areas at affordable rates, thereby empowering communities through entrepreneurial action. These soaps are made by a group of HIV/AIDS-affected women from the Samepur Badli slum in Rohini, Delhi, yet another poverty-ridden slum with scant resources.
Statistics prove that the HIV-infected population faces three times higher unemployment than the national unemployment rate. 88% of HIV-positive married Indian women experience social stigma and blatant discrimination. We reached out to women who were willing to work and create an identity of their own through an NGO called Navjeevan Seva Mandal. We organized a workshop session wherein professionals from Craftivity Training Center taught our target audience the melt and pour process of soap making, and these women received certification in the same.
Under the project, we collect pre-used soap bars from hotels, which are then recycled into new soap bars made in three fragrances, namely lavender, lotus, and rose. We ensure that they are duly tested by Delhi Test House to warrant the finest quality. After this, the soap is packaged, labeled, and sold using the differential pricing strategy. During a course of action, we conducted an interactive session with slum women in Chandigarh, wherein we spread awareness about sanitation.
Project IFAT's consistent growth has led to considerable revenue generation, which has benefited an array of individuals. We have trained four women entrepreneurs who have earned a total income of 1,54,467 rupees annually. We have also employed 10 salesmen who have received a total commission of 24,900 rupees in the previous year. In addition, IFAT was a recipient of the prestigious KPMG Business Ethics Grant for two consecutive years. Our impact goes way beyond the bounds of financial earnings and stretches its arms into the arena of collaborations, partnerships, environmental campaigns, exhibitions, awareness events, and webinars, amongst others. For the procurement of used soaps, we have partnered with hotels like Crown Plaza in Rohini, Ramada in Gurgaon, The Park in Connaught Place, Cozy Grand in Arkipuram, and clubs like V Club and Florence Club in Gurgaon.
This year, Project IFAT transcended the geographical bounds of our country by collaborating with Tilburg University, Netherlands. Through exchanging insights, we succeeded in propagating the management of restaurant and hotel waste at an international platform, and hence realized our goal of revitalizing global partnerships to achieve sustainable development. Additionally, we were associated with the Be Good Tribe for their Four Earth event, which witnessed a footfall of over 6,000 people. It was aimed at promoting sustainable ways of living and sensible waste management. In line with this ideology, IFAT also took up the task of selling its repurposed soaps by setting up stalls at venues like Garden Estates, a housing society in Gurugram, and various colleges. In an effort to extend aid across vulnerable communities, IFAT engaged with an NPO called RVOIX, with whom we conducted several educational workshops. We also conducted a workshop in collaboration with Project Zero Waste, titled Sustainable Living in the Post-COVID World, which focused on the minimization of waste.
We have garnered media attention from notable media houses like Blue Leaves Community and the University Store. To enable the cause of HIV/AIDS to take center stage, we initiated a social media campaign to stop the stigma surrounding the disease, which had a digital reach of 20,000 plus individuals worldwide. Part of this campaign was a poster making and slogan writing competition for school students in order to stimulate their thoughts and give them a platform to express their awareness on this issue. Our outreach partners for this include NGOs such as Pratisandhi and Chetnalaya. In light of the global pandemic, we, in collaboration with Chetnalaya, are proactively partaking in a sanitation drive where we have donated over 100 soaps, 350 sanitary napkins, 50 phenyl bottles and glucose packets each, thus impacting over 200 individuals.
With the onset of COVID-19, our project was at a major crossroad as our raw material supply from hotels started declining and production came to a standstill. For a project in its prime, such an obstacle would have led to a break in momentum. However, for us, this moment posed itself as a window for re-envisioning and prioritizing the diversification of this project. Paper soaps are a simple solution to the problem of contact-based contamination. The growing emphasis on the need for washing hands is what encouraged us to take up this product. People use locomotives extensively and are predisposed to viral transmissions from the unknown. Paper soaps are the perfect match to this problem. They are convenient to use, portable, easy to dispose, biodegradable, and just as effective as conventional soaps.
Since our idea is at its primary stage of development, it was important that we had a holistic understanding of the ground reality. Through our need assessment survey, it was clear that the unskilled and semi-skilled workers who travel during the day mostly neglect their health. This is an outcome of improper hygiene practices and inaccessibility to proper resources. Thus, as our first phase of initiation, a batch of 500 paper soaps was made by our team and successfully distributed among the auto and rickshaw drivers who come in contact with currency and multiple people each and every day. Once we've assisted the vulnerable, we plan on expanding this initiative into a sustainable business model. Keeping our immunocompromised beneficiaries' well-being as the top priority, we decided to start production on our own. Subsequently, we trained them in the process of making the paper soaps for when we return to normalcy. We aim to make this product available to a wider audience for increased sales, which we hope would be a turning point for Project IFAT.
Being a team which strongly believes in creating eco-friendly products, we intend to encourage people to make greener choices and change the current status quo. One such choice is that of using a floor cleaner free of harmful and polluting chemicals for homes and offices. Made from natural ingredients like fruit peels, our floor cleaners are biodegradable, hypoallergenic, and safe for the use of adults and children alike. For procuring the raw materials, we aim to collaborate with juice vendors. The chemicals used in synthetic cleaners, on the other hand, are potentially hazardous to health and lead to water and soil pollution. Contrary to common perception that organic products are more expensive than synthetic ones, our product is cheaper in comparison to its chemical counterparts.
We plan to sell them only after getting them approved by a certified agency where testing had previously been halted due to the advent of COVID-19.
मेरा नाम विमला है और मैं बिहार की रहने वाली हूँ। 2004 में मेरे पति की डेथ हो गई। 2017 में मैं जेएमसी कॉलेज स्टूडेंट के साथ जुड़ी हूँ। उनके साथ जुड़ के साबुन बनाने का काम सीखा है। मतलब पूरी तरीके से मुझे बनाना आ गया है। अब मैं सीख रही और मैं अपने पैरों पर खड़ी हूँ। पूरे साबुन बनाने का काम मैं अकेले कर सकती हूँ। और नए नए लेडीज हो गए जितने आते हैं उनको भी हम सिखाते हैं ताकि वो भी सीख सकें, वो भी अपने पैरों पर खड़ी हो सकें।
With evolution and innovation at the crux of what we stand for, we aspire to do better for the world around us with each passing year. Project IFAT is now proud to fulfill 10 out of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. Under it, we were able to recycle and repurpose 1,332 kgs of soap waste. In the past year, IFAT has touched the lives of 41,296 people indirectly, and through our efforts, we have managed to save 2,932 liters of water.
IFAT has garnered the attention and engagement of 4,55,741 people digitally. This impact is a fruit of the joint effort that we undertook with the help of 20 plus collaborations during our journey, in addition to working in congruence with Tilburg University in the Netherlands to highlight the need for waste management. The sanctity of IFAT is best exemplified by our mantra, which is to transform the oppressed women of yesterday to the new age entrepreneurs of tomorrow.